So you watched a bunch of videos on YouTube and you decided turboing my car is the best idea ever. It's going to be wonderful. Well, there's definitely a lot of stuff to think about. This car has a little bit of a history with us. It first came to us, the turbo went bad. It had a built K20 in it, a 2 liter. And essentially the seal in the turbo went bad, so it started sucking all the oil out, starved the engine of oil. You know, we put a new turbo on it, found out it needed an engine. We put this engine in there. This is a K24, it's a 2.4 liter. And in doing so, he drove it for a little bit until it got tuned. He went to go get tuned, and when he drove it for a little bit, he, you know, drove it cautiously. He didn't, you know, go off rev limiter or floor it everywhere. He just drove the car around. He went to go get it tuned to make sure that it was running properly. And the tuner, who's a good friend of ours, he said that they weren't able to control the boost to be less than 13 PSI. Now, on some four cylinders, 13 PSI is not a lot. On this four cylinder, 13 PSI was almost 450 wheel horsepower, which wheel horsepower means that the crank horsepower was probably over 500 because of math. This engine is stock, it's not built. And the reason why it couldn't control the boost, but it could on the 2 liter, is because of airflow. This engine creates more air because of stroke, piston size, the valves in it, so on and so forth. It creates more air than the 2 liter did, which this is a wastegate. This is actually what controls the air on your turbo to control boost. So essentially, it takes the exhaust from the engine and bypasses the turbo out some sort of tube, either recirculating or not, and that keeps the turbo from spooling more, which is why your boost will go to a point and then kind of stop there. This tube isn't big enough for a 2 liter. So because of that, and because, you know, this is like engine number 4 with this car. He's had the car a really long time, but he just wants it to be good. He's not looking for 400 or 500 horsepower. He wants somewhere in the 300 horsepower range. We're going to put a much bigger wastegate on it, and that's why we're here. So this is the wastegate that we're going to be putting on. So this is a 60 millimeter. This is a 45. So essentially, I'm going to have to cut this tube off of the manifold so that I can mate this piece to it and then put the wastegate on there and make a new dump tube to get the exhaust gases out of the engine bay. But it takes a lot of measuring and everything to get this done, and apparently we weren't going to know until he went to a tuner that this engine created way too much boost for the engine to actually handle with this turbo. And these engines do make around 400 if you boost them and stuff like that, but when you can't control the boost, that's when bad things happen. And essentially with this one, it broke a piston. So this is going to be the replacement engine for that one. However, because I have to do a lot of cutting and all the other stuff, I'm going to do the cutting and grinding and so on and so forth on that engine. This is going to go in once I get the wastegate taken care of. That's going to be the goal with this one, is essentially getting our new wastegate on, and then getting the new engine in so he can go get tuned, make less boost, controllable boost, and keep his engine together. Now that we're at a point to where I feel comfortable cutting into this and not hurting the turbo or anything, you may be asking, how am I going to know that this isn't going to hit the car when I put the new one on? Before we took it out, with my phone, I took some pictures with a tape measure of how far this stuff was from the actual firewall. And then, because we don't have the firewall, so on and so forth, and I'm gonna be cutting this off, so it's not going to be here, I measured how far this tube, this wastegate, and everything were from the block, and took pictures as well. So hopefully I have enough references for me to do this properly and not screw anything up. the hole has to be as close to this size as possible, or else it's still only going to be the 45 millimeter hole that was on there, or whatever actual size that is, because I don't know if that's actually 45 millimeters there. Well, I have the ugly part on. Granted, yes, it's much bigger than the manifold, and yes, it's not a great fit, but this was the cheapest way to do it, and that's what the customer wants. So either that, or it was getting a completely new style manifold, new downpipe, intercooler piping, having to remake everything, and definitely a comma would be involved in the extra cost. So we hopped on this train, and we're putting this in, that way I can do that. But now that that's on, I'm going to put the turbo on, and this is still the bad engine, so. But I'm gonna put the turbo on so I can make the dump tube. And the dump tube is what actually routes the exhaust away from the engine. But I need all of this stuff in place so that I can design the dump tube and make sure my measurements are still working. A little tight, that's okay. So I have the tape wrapped around, and then we do a mark so that the mark goes on both pieces of tape. And now you just take the tape off and we lay it down, and that's the diameter of the pipe. And so we want half of the diameter so that we have the other side. That's pretty much 19 centimeters on the dot. So half of 19 is 9.5. So we put a mark at 9.5, which is actually 10.5 because I have the one there. So that is center. Now we just put the tape back around and line up our two marks over top each other. See? They line up. And then we have the other side. So now we take the straight edge, butt it up against that, have it come down here, draw a line, go to the other side, draw a line, and then I'll show you in there how I do each pie cut and why these two lines matter. Okay. So I'm gonna do the marks for how far I want the pieces apart. Now we're making the dump tube with all the pie cuts that I was cutting. I think I'm gonna have to do a few more pie cuts, but we're gonna do another like 4-inch extension here and then down this way. Don't worry, this is actually in the wrong spot right now. It's supposed to be back here. So it'll be more out of the way than what it is right now. But I'm definitely liking how everything is coming out for where it's sitting. This is how far I want it to be. These are super close. Everything is welded. Definitely much easier to do the dump tube than the manifold. But according to all my measurements that I took beforehand, everything is within how, like, the distances that I need. We'll probably do a video later of like fitment and like, you know, it running, and hopefully everything works great at the dyno and all that stuff. But yeah, we just wanted to fill you in on some of the weird stuff that we have to do for customers here. And this one definitely fell under the weirdness.